That was just
silly.
But back to you in terms of how have you evolved? What's been the evolution in your own politics? I mean, for example, you were very strong in terms of the threat of radical fundamentalist jihadism.
Still am.
I know.
Yes, I think liberals should stop booing me for pointing out that Islam is not like other religions, that is a unique threat, and that
But it's not Islam you're against. It's
all religions are stupid. They are.
Yeah.
I mean, I doubt if you're really religious. It'd be very hard for me to believe that you actually believe in these intellectually embarrassing anachronisms from the Bronze Age. Do you really believe in the Bible, the Bible which supports slavery, which is pro-polygamy, believes a guy lived inside of a whale?
As you know from this program, I'm a devotee of science, too.
Right. Okay. So I heard.
But I want covering all bets.
I saw Howard Dean on TV the other day.
I did.
And he said something along the order of, the people in ISIS are. I said, I'm about as Islamic as they are. You know, distancing the vast numbers Islamic people around the world from it. That's just not true.
It is true.
It is not true, Charlie. There is a connecting tissue between.
Behind every Muslim is a future member of some radical...
Let me finish.
I thought I was doing that.
There are illiberal beliefs that are held by vast numbers of Muslim people that I don't think...
Vast number of Christians, too.
No, that's not true. Not true. Vast numbers of Christians do not believe that if you leave the Christian religion, you should be killed for it. Vast numbers of Christians do not treat women as second-class citizens. Vast numbers of Christians
do not believe
that if you draw a picture of Jesus Christ, you should get killed for it. So, yes, does ISIS do Khmer Rouge-like activities where they just kill people indiscriminately who aren't just like them? Yes. And would most Muslim people in the world do that or condone that? No. But most Muslim people in the world do condone violence. Just for what you think. They do. First of all, they say it. They shout it from the
vast majorities of Muslims.
Absolutely.
Say that?
There's a Pew poll of Egypt done a few years ago. 82%, I think it was, said stoning is the appropriate punishment for adultery. Over 80% thought death was the appropriate punishment for leaving the Muslim religion. I'm sure you know these things.
I know. I do.
So to claim that this religion is like other religions is just naive and plain wrong. It is not like other religions. New York Times pointed out in an op-ed a couple of weeks ago that in Saudi Arabia, just since August 4th, I think it was, they have beheaded 19 people, most for nonviolent crimes, including homosexuality.
They didn't get the hands off the thief.
Right. Okay. So we're upset that ISIS is beheading people, which we should be upset about. But Saudi Arabia does it, and they're our good friends because they have oil.
Right.
Okay? But they do it, too. This is the center of the religion. I'm not saying...
They're now fighting against ISIS, too. They're joining us in the fight, as is the Emirates.
They are both fighting ISIS, and they are for ISIS.
Well, not the government. I mean, some of the
private... Certainly the government.
It's a bit like today... about Qatar. It's a big story in the New York Times, which you may
absolutely
have seen today about Qatar.
Yeah, but
and there's some guy there is supporting who's a Muslim in
Qatar. I mean, in Mecca, where infidels, non-Muslims, are not even allowed in the holy parts of the city. I mean, right there. We don't have that example in other religions. Okay, they do behead people. Now, if they were beheading people in Vatican City, which is the equivalent of Mecca don't you think there'd be a bigger outcry about it? So this is the soft bigotry of low expectations
that we have with
Muslim people. When they do crazy things and believe crazy things, somehow it's just not talked about nearly as much.
Would you come to this table and have a debate about this with a moderate Muslim?
Find one, yes. Find one.
I promise you,
find a Muslim.
I do believe that what we see with ISIS is not representative of...
As I said, connecting tissue.
It's not representative of the Islamic religion.
Again,
I don't think the Quran teaches them to do this kind of thing.
Well, you're wrong about that. The Quran absolutely has on every page stuff that's horrible about how the infidel should be treated. But, for example, again, ISIS says that they should perform genital mutilation on all women 11 to 46. Right. Would most Muslims agree with that? No. Or right. carry it out? No. But as Ayan Hirsi Ali points out, she says, can women are treated equally in the Muslim world? I mean, their testimony in court is very often counted as half. They need permission to leave the house in some places.
But a lot of moderate Muslims would say, in fact, one of the things that we need to modernize is the idea of the way we treat women. Lots of them.
But in this country, if you just use the wrong word about women, they go nuts. And in all these other countries, they're doing things like making them wear burqas, and I hear liberals say things like, well, they want to. They've been brainwashed. You know, they don't want it. It's like saying a streetwalker wants to do that.
So let me just talk about this, because I find this interesting, too.